Matthew McConaughey. But even in the silent era, trains were a major recurring part of movies. In 1923, trains were a major part of La Rue, Abel Gance's 9-hour epic. In 1926, much of Exit Smiling, a comedy...
Warning, warning, 3030 on the horizon. This is not a drill. Repeat, this is not a drill.
Goodbye 20s, hello 30s. Yes, as of the day this video is coming to your feed, I am turning 30 years old. From looking cute like this to looking like this, all self-deprecation jokes aside, I'm still growing and learning as I think everyone still is doing. Just wait until I do my 40-year-old video, if I feel like doing it. But one thing I always found very interesting about me, at least for the United States, four different type of movies came out the day I came out of my mom. Yeah, remember when there was more variety when going to the theater and you could just sell a movie that has a profile shot of an actor and somehow make bank? Now it's just showing a superhero without their mask on so you can know who the big name actor is, but it's poorly made because it's trying to do a Drew Struzan poster, but it's what an AI think is a Drew Struzan poster. Regardless, let's talk about four movies that I share sentiment with, strictly because we're in the same age. Leon the Professional, Star Trek Generations, Swan Princess, and The Miracle on 34th Street remake. So, let's start with the only movie you should watch out of these. So I'm sort of cheating with this one. Leon actually came out September 14th in France. In the US of A, it's November 18th, so ha! Let me just say, if you're wondering who should watch this movie, it's clearly
everyone!
I've seen the list alongside some of the greats as one of the best action films ever made, and surprisingly, I've never put this film in the action genre. Yes, it's breathtaking, but why it's breathtaking is strictly because of the characters of Leon and Mathilda is beautifully executed, that when the action is going on, you're less likely to go, ooh, gunfire, and more so, oh no, I hope they make it out. Very similar to my thoughts on Terminator 2, but I prefer T2 over Leon. Not saying this movie has nothing to say, it's fun, it's touching, and little Natalie Portman in her first role. I say little and she's 14. There's a lot to unpack in this movie, and that just talking about it won't give you the satisfaction I think you'd get from talking about it. So, get to it, and again, make sure you get
EVERYONE
to watch it. So let me start by saying one thing. My mom loves the original Miracle. I remember her turning on every Christmas, and she quoted a lot of things from the film too.
Faith is believing in things when common sense tells you not to.
The reason I bring this up because whenever the remake turned on our TVs, she had merely changed the channel. Heck, Macy's didn't want to be involved with this movie. But when doing my research for the movie, I was surprised to learn that Gene Siskel and Roger Ebert gave it two thumbs up versus
two thumbs down for The Professional, which is just stylish tripe from the director of the much better film.
That's a death sentence to a lot of people. So I went in curious, and I can clearly say, while not as good as the original, this is a sweet movie. Just like the original, there is a lot of heart I was not expecting here. And to think, the week before this got released, we got The Santa Claus. You can watch this just fine and appreciate Richard Attenborough's Santa performance. He's not my favorite, but something about his childlike performance and smile just wins me over. Mara Wilson is great as well, but it's her cute performance from Mrs. Doubtfire with a hint of wit from Matilda. I think everyone in this film does a great job at capturing the spirit of Christmas and making this little movie about a court case and Santa Claus all the better. I, of course, love the original, but I think the remake shouldn't be ignored, but cherished. Remember the Disney Renaissance? Well, this is one of the many attempts other studios tried to do to compete with Disney. So much so, I think Disney was afraid this movie was going to be a hit, so they re-released The Lion King this same week.
Returning to theaters everywhere, November 18th.
Making this movie a box office bomb. And is the movie any good per se?
No.
I don't really like this movie, and I think it's very backwards on how it handles the plot. What I mean is the prince and princess meet each other when they're kids, they don't like each other, but then they cut to when they're legal, and then the main plot begins. Sorry, but I wish they focus on them being kids, being cutesy brats, and somehow gaining a friendship. They don't have to get married at the end, but what we have here, it's not good enough as it can be. Heck, even the animation isn't that great in areas with a lot of noticeable mistakes. And no one is interested, not even the big baddie who seems to make up side effects of Odette's curse.
You see, you've forgotten one very important thing tomorrow night. There is no moon.
And the movie even rips off Little Mermaid, which I don't know if Swan Lake had a plot thread first, but I'm too lazy to fact check. I don't know, if this was your first non-Disney princess film when you were growing up, good on you. You got like 10 sequels to watch if you haven't already. So here's a fun backstory. This was the first Star Trek related thing I ever watched. I remember my dad put it on because we got a big TV and a great sound system for our living room, and the scene of the Enterprise crashing left a huge impact on me. But the opening to Star Wars still takes that ticket for what left the bigger impact. I didn't know what the movie was until years later when I finally decided to watch the original series and eventually The Next Generation. When I first laid my eyes on Data, I knew I've seen these people before. Overall, I have a soft spot for this movie. From its cheese to its character moments and how it handles the legacy makes me think this is one of the few good odd-number Star Trek films. Don't ask me to rank them. Only thing I don't really care about is Data's subplot with the emotion chip. My thoughts?
I hate this!
I do, however, consider this whole movie like an extended version of the show with a higher budget. So if you like The Next Generation, this movie is right up your alley. But the next film, First Contact, is the better movie by a mile. I might be making myself sound like I am a bit negative, even though I've claimed I've had a soft spot for it. But that's honestly because I can say I am glad I saw this movie when I did. And seeing Stewart and Shatner on the same shot together just was so comforting back then. And just as comforting as it is now. So now that I'm done talking about movies that came out when I was born, do you have any movies you share a birthday with? I know someone who shared a birthday with James and the Giant Peach, which really made me jealous, and let's be honest, their personality, it made a lot of sense. And I of course have a bunch of other movies that came out on my birthday, but not the year I was born. Write down in the comments, I'm looking forward to reading them. That in mind, I hope you guys have a great day, and take care.